Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Tuesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 64th mission of the year, Starlink 7-2 on a Falcon 9 rocket.
One ignition. Lift off of Falcon 9. Go SpaceX. Go Starlink Group 7-2.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1071, then landed successfully for the 11th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 2 FTS was saved.
Landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
Coming up this week, we can hopefully expect another Starlink mission to launch. The Starlink 616 mission is scheduled for Friday 15th at 12:45 a.m. UTC or tomorrow, Thursday 14th at 8:45 p.m. EDT. Axiom Space posted information about the next crewed Axiom mission that will launch on Dragon capsule. It says, announcing astronaut crew for Axiom Mission 3, AX3, set to launch to International Space Station no earlier than January 2024. First ever all-European commercial astronaut mission to the orbiting laboratory redefining the pathway to low Earth orbit. There was a press release by Telesat regarding a whole bunch of satellites that will be launched by SpaceX. It says Telesat has contracted 14 launches on SpaceX's Falcon 9, the most reliable and only reusable orbital rocket flying today, which will carry up to 18 Telesat Lightspeed satellites to low Earth orbit per launch. The launch campaign is scheduled to commence in 2026 and will take advantage of SpaceX's high launch cadence to rapidly deploy the satellites and enable Telesat to begin providing global service in 2027. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a look at the launch site. SpaceX was seen performing a test of the orbital launch mount's FireX system. Work continues in the production yard on the Mega Bay 2 building. The Ship 22 nose cone was recently painted white. The chopsticks were seen moved and closed around Ship 25. Last week, the Ship 26 prototype was moved from the rocket garden to the launch site. Ship 26 was also lifted onto the Pad B test mount for its test campaign. As always, I have to say thanks to both Sean Doherty and Jack Beyer for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.